just a few days' work. I got to tell you, though, one of the best reality shows on TV is that goddamn stupid crab fishing show. I don't know how I got caught up in that thing.
The hell is the crab fishing show?
The most dangerous catch on Discovery Channel. You ever hear about this?
No.
They put cameras on a bunch of these ships that go out into the Bering Sea in Alaska.
I thought they put cameras on toilet seats.
No.
No. It's like, what are you talking about? Crab fishing.
Crab fishing. They put them on all these crabbing boats, and they go out into the Bering Sea. They're by Alaska, and they go crabbing. Now, you'd think, okay, how is that a TV show? Apparently, this is like one of the most dangerous jobs in the world. People dying all the time. And it's a reality show because they follow these people's lives and personalities and their jobs. And what we've always wanted to see on reality shows, people are dropping dead.
Really?
People are dying. They show the captain of some ship showing how to put on some emergency gear. And then they're out on a boat, and one of the cameramen see a captain on the radio. And ship capsized, sunk. The captain that was just doing the little thing on his gear, and six of his crewmen are dead, and another guy falls overboard. He's dead. People are getting injured all the time. This is reality. Why else would you watch a crab fishing show?
They ought to,
like, ooh, I hope they bring up a bunch of crabs.
They ought to interview the crabs. New deaths every week.
It's like a holocaust. The crab holocaust. Unbelievable. But I got roped into watching this. I'm watching it now all the time. Most dangerous catch.
I never knew the show was on TV. Yeah.
I sit there going, doing the Regan bit. I'm watching fishing. I'm not even fishing. I'm watching fishing.
But is the crab show, there's no it's just being filmed. There's no phony reality angle, right? It's just really
no, it's just
filmed.
These guys. They're all a little kooky to be out there. They work for, it's only a few days, a couple of times a year that they do this. And they could walk away with upwards of 10, 15 grand each for just a few days' work. But it's just the worst job ever.
There's no immunity challenge?
No, no challenges. No, actually, they do have a Budweiser-sponsored crab count with which ship brings in the most pounds of crab. They should have, like, a body count because people are dropping dead. There was one ship just keeled over. And they found out that they had too many of these crab traps on it, and it was top-heavy, overloaded. The captain, yeah, screwed up and paid with his life.
Was that by Lake Gitchagouni? Was it going from Cleveland into Canada somewhere, and it was a storm?
The Edmund Fitzgerald? Well, our crab pots were full, and we came into shore, and...
I really like that song.
Jimmy was asking his questions.
That stupid Gordon Lightfoot.
The song goes on forever.
I love it,
Jesus
though.
The water was at my ankles, and the song goes on another hour.
Is that the song that makes you just get all tingly, Jimmy?
I just like it, because I like the fact that he's doing a 40-minute ballad about
the wreck
a
of the Edmund Fitzgerald. Yeah. I looked at the fuel gauge, it was 3/4 full, and we motored on toward our destination.
And then we bought a Rolls Royce on eBay.
Hey, we could kill 7 minutes. Let this play today.
God. He asked for my money back. He said, drop dead, you horse tooth Jew. You're getting nothing back.
Lives on from the Chippewa on down of the big lake they call Gitchagumi.
All right.
The lake, it is said, never gives up for dead when the skies of November turn gloomy.
Gloomy. Get your gloomy with gloomy.
With a load of iron ore, 26,000 tons more than the Edmund Fitzgerald weighed empty.
I smelt bad from fish and put on perfumey.
That good ship and true was a bone to be chewed when the gales of November came early.
They cast off yet? We untied the bow line and untied the stern, and I started the engine with a turn of the key. Jesus, every friggin' step of the way of the Edmund Fitzgerald. We get it already.
We get it. You're on a boat.
I took a compass heading of 135, and I turned the wheel, and the purser got me my coffee. I take it light and sweet, but he made it too dark, and I sent him back to the galley.
Right, what happened? What happened next?
I went to sleep and I had sleep paralysis, and I woke up to the exorcist face in my bed.
It goes on forever.
The wind and the wire made a tattletale sound.
Watch.
And the wave over the railing.
This song's only half over and I still see the dock.
The captain did too. Twas the witch of November come stealing.
I forgot my wallet in my car, so we turned the ship around. And we docked again, and I figured I'd stop for a beer.
When afternoon came, it was freezing rain.
Tune in and 2 hours later when the ship finally sinks. Enough! And then they're dark. Throw in a musical interlude to make it longer. Christ! I put on my life vest and helped my crew put it on, too, and we stood there, and, well, the water's now up to our knees.
See, look, there's...
All right, we'll just kind of...
It's still going!
We'll take a few phone calls, and we'll go back to the song in a minute. Scott in Arizona. What's up, Scott?
Hey, how you guys doing this morning?
Pretty good. What's up?
Hey, don't get me wrong here. You guys are great, man. I mean, love the shit out of you guys.
Oh,
but
sure.
I got a little complaint about the crabbing thing. I spent 15 years up in Alaska commercial fishing, and then I just got my big truck this morning, and boom, first thing I turned you guys on this morning, you guys complaining about the show.
What?
Yeah.
Who's complaining?
Oh, you said you didn't like it. And then you're making fun of a bunch of...
I love the crab show. That's what I was saying. Were you listening or were you like me?
He likes
not
to.
Listening.
You better listen to the replay to
listen
hear
to
what
the
you
replay.
Missed.
I love the crab show. I said I can't stop watching it.
Oh, I apologize then. My brain fart.
My thing was I was saying that all crabbers are bums and incompetents. Anthony was disagreeing.
Well, I have to agree with you there.
All right, thank you. We're going to move on.
Tad again from San Francisco. I watched the History Channel show on the Edmund Fitzgerald. It took 3 minutes for the boat to sink, so it takes longer for the song to play than it took for the boat to actually sink.
Well, let's see where the song is.
All right, where are we?
Wired in, he had water coming in, and the good ship and crew was in peril.
All right, it's all just right, starting to sink.
So we'll go back to the song in a little while and see what happens. Let's take a couple
I said,
while.
Hey, dude, what do you think about this? He said, I don't know, there might be a hole in the boat. So we went down to the engine room, and yeah, there was a hole, and we sat and smoked a cigarette or two. Because it really wasn't that bad.
Let's say hi to Alex in Boston. Alex?
Hey, guys.
Hey.
I got 2 points. Jimmy, don't you play the most dangerous catch every night?
That's not bad.
Not bad.
Jimmy tangling with some tainted vagina.
It's me on a boat with 3 Craigslist prostitutes.
And crabs are involved also. So. Very
and,
nice.
And Rick Crab Ross joke? Buys a car like people buy drugs. Give him the money first, wait, and I'll come back with the car.
Uh-oh. Oh, boy. You should have started with that one.
Speaking of cars.
All right. Thank you, sir.
Thanks,
sir. Thank you, Jimmy. Let's go back to the song and see where Gordon Lightfoot is. At.
Uh-oh. I think that's down.
Yeah.
All right, we'll check back. He's still in that musical interlude
who's
there.
That, who's that other ballad singer? Oh, Steve Flamefoot. He's my favorite. The captain wired in and the water coming in.
Oh, Steve Flamefoot.
Oh, 27,000 tons more than the Edmund Fitzgerald. Jesus, he separated the T and the Z.
We have a little problem. The stripples, they won't take their clothes off.
Stripples?
The stripples. Yes, they're kind of like an Australian children's naked singing group.
All right, before we go to break, let's see where Gordon Lightfoot is here.
All right.
He's still going.
Music.
Does anyone know where the love of God goes when the waves turn the minutes to hours?
Minutes to hours.
The searchers all say they'd have made Whitefish Bay if they'd put 15 more miles behind her. They might have split up or they might have capsized. They may have broke deep and took water. And all that remains is the faces and the names of the wives and the sons and the daughters.
All right, we'll go back to Gordon Lightfoot after the break. He's still singing along.
Now he's singing about the survivors and everything.
Like, the wife remarried and had 3 kids and can't even remember his name. Been 15 years and now I'm going to sing about his children's experience in elementary school.
It's a bit of a long tune.
Oh, Christ! I think we were making that point, Jimmy.
Oh, that's true. I just jump in like, hey, guys, I have a thought. That's a long song.
Long song.
Gordon, you come.
Gordon Lightfoot. Heavy on the pen, though.
And my typewriter ran out of ink.
Yeah, he doesn't get to the end yet. Oh, that's hilarious. Let's go to Chris in New Jersey. Chris, what's up?
Hey, what's going on, guys? Hey. How you doing, Chicken Lips?
That's very mean-spirited.
What?
What?
What's painful?
What?
That fucking song, that Gordon Lightfoot song.
You don't like that song?
No, dude, it's fucking horrible.
It's not horrible.
Yeah.
Oh, it's terrible.
What do you prefer? What kind of song do you prefer, if I could just jump in and make a relative comparison?
Anything but that.
That's a little vague, sir.
I'll listen to Brother Joe's Journey covers, you know. But right. This is all I had to say. First of all, Loverboy did not do that fucking song at the outfield, that I Want to Lose Your Love Tonight.
Oh, yeah, that was the outfield. Very good.
And Night Ranger's other song was Don't Tell Me You Love Me.
Oh, that's right.
Oh,
okay,
that was a huge
good.
Hit.
Yeah, I remember that
there
one.
Thank you, Chris. Very informative.
You don't like Gordon Lightfoot, but you know Night Ranger and Loverboy songs from 1981.
Right. Yeah, well, come on, dude. 1981, I was around then. Like, I wasn't around when that song come out, that Gordon Lightfoot.
I'm guessing in the mid-70s, probably after the actual accident.
All right.
Yeah, my parents were eating granola, and I wasn't born yet, so.
All right, thank you, Chris.
All right, guys.
We got to get back to Gordon Lightfoot. Where is he at in this stupid song of his?
Lake Huron rolls, Superior scenes, in the rooms of her ice water mansion. Oh, Michigan steams like a young man's dreams. The islands and bays are for sportsmen.
Then the sun supernova, then the earth was burned to a crisp. And it's 50 billion years in the future.
Takes in what Lake Erie can send her.
All right, we'll get back
to
going.
We wear Mylar suits and we colonize Mars.
And Danny finally got a sign on the TV show. God, did I fuck that one up? And Danny finally got a sign on the TV show. I wouldn't hurt you, Danny. I love every goddamn half a sign on your head.
And when should we take Danny to see a doctor?
As soon as possible. Oh, I'm an asshole. Danny.
Oh, that's funny. Devin from New Hampshire. Andrea Yates played that song as she drowned her kid.
And the next one looked up and said, hey, what's going on here, Mom?
When the bubbles stop, four more to go.
And the workers all went, shit. And the searchers all say, they'd have made 21 if this bitch had taken her medicine. Five little unopened boxes under the tree.
Well, speaking of Gordon Lightfoot,
and two disappointed grandparents.
Let's see where Gordon is in the song.
As I set off to sail from Modesto. A splash and a tear as my wife disappeared neath the blue briny waters of Modesto.
Are we finally at the end?
I don't know. No.
Oh. Is that it?
In a musty old hall in Detroit, they prayed in the Maritime Sailors Cathedral.
Oh, geez, they're praying now.
The church bell chimes and it rang 29 times.
Five
for
times.
Each man on the Edmund Fitzgerald. The legend lives on from the Chippewa on down of the big lake they call
down
it
to that
half-bath.
All
right, we'll get back to Gordon Lightfoot.
I just want to hear the line where he says, and a grandmother's wasted charm bracelet.
As Grandma sadly looks at the bottle of Johnson's baby shampoo.
unceremoniously dumps it in the toilet.
Because it's useless.
And the quack of a rubber ducky in the trash pail.
What is wrong with you? You're the worst.
Holy jeez. That is hysterically awful.
Oh. Oh, my chest.
Let's see if we can get to the end
Susan
of the song.
Susan Smith hold sent on, the on. Van down the boat ramp. Two little tykes in their car seats.
She said, you little cock blockers, it's been nice to know you.
The big one said, Mommy, why's we going backwards?
And she went on the news and pointed that Coco had taken her children.
Speaking of the song, let's see if let's see where Gordon Lightfoot is.
Oh, there it is. Fading out. Wow.
Finally, we made it to the end.
Thank God. I got tears coming down my cheeks.
Hey, let's say hi to Scott. Scott, what's up?
Hey, dude. Why don't you guys bring your show to a screeching hall and play Alice's Restaurant?
It's not Thanksgiving.
That's right. NEW played that for years, the waste product.
NEW, when we worked there, they were so proud of the fact that they played Alice's Restaurant every Thanksgiving morning.
Yeah.
And to this day, I don't really get what the tie-in is.
How long is the song? Is it a long song?
The song
well,
is
the
like,
whole gist is that it's Thanksgiving in the song.
The song is like 20 minutes long.
Yeah. I just get to listen to the song to realize what it meant in Thanksgiving time.
Yeah. All right. Thank you, Scott.
I'm out.
Let's say hi to Sally in Illinois. Sally?
Hi. If you want to waste another half hour, play MacArthur Park.
Oh, Jesus.
I never could even understand that one.
Yeah.
Or I'll never have that recipe again.
Yeah, why did someone leave a cake out in the rain?
Yeah. Who would,
it took so long to bake it.
Who would be silly enough to leave a cake out in the rain?
Someone did. And then I don't think that I can take it because it took so long to bake it, and I'll never have that recipe again. Yep. Jesus, God.
Who did that song originally? Because there's a million versions of it.
I never paid attention. I tried not to.
Yeah, all right.
I think I know that. I think that I can take. Is that how it goes?
Yeah. Wait, okay. Go over this way. Yeah, that's the version right there. Let me say more. Yeah, let me see if that's...
I'm still recouping.
I know, that's why we're just kind of... Let's see what this is. Go.
Oh.
By David Sim? Or Sim?
Is this an instrumental?
No.
Sounds like an instrumental. The one that was a hit was done by
that's what I'm asking.
By the actor. What's his name?
Vic Damone?
No.
Andy Williams?
No.
What
the hell is his name?
Jerry
Roman Polanski?
I don't know.
Someone left the 14-year-old out in the rain.
Someone left the cake out in the rain and it had 13 candles on it.
That's right, you want 13.
Apparently, someone left some semen on some granimals, too. Stupid.
I don't think that I should fuck it.
I was trying to raise my own, but Manson's a cock blocker.
Jesus. I don't know.
Richard.
Yeah, Richard. Mm-hmm.
What's his name?
Harris?
Richard Harris. Richard Harris.
Richard Harris did this song?
He was an orca.
Yeah. Everyone did this song. Didn't Paul Anka do it?
It's only 7.5 minutes long. This is a short one.
This big long piano horn intro.
Spring was never waiting for us, girl. It ran one step ahead as we followed in the dance.
What? What is he even saying?
Between the parted pages and were pressed in love's hot fevered iron like a striped pair of pants.
Someone left the children in the tub.
Oh my God, we can't do it.
This goes on and on.
I wish I had more hands so I could kill more than two at a time.
Yeah, Todd makes a good point from Florida.